how do you animate between two different routes in React Router? Well, today, with Frame of Motion, we're going to do just that.
This is Coding with Seth. Let's get started.
Frame of Motion is a React animation library. If you haven't watched my first video, and you'd like to set up an animation in around 5 minutes, then have a look at the video right here. Transitions in React Router don't have to be hard. Let's harness Frame of Motion so we can animate the transitions between different routes.
Let's start off with the basic React app. As you can see, we've got a browser router from React Router DOM, and we're just wrapping our app inside that. Next, we'll jump over to app.js. This contains everything we need to get through the tutorial. We can see the basic layout to the right. We have a navigation containing nav links. These are the links which allow us to navigate between each page. We also define the routes, about, settings, and home. You can see the corresponding components here. These are basic components to act as pages you might see in a real-world application. The first step is to import AnimatePresence from Frame of Motion. AnimatePresence allows us to trigger animations on components when they mount and unmount. This is useful for the transitions we're doing with React Router, because when we change between the different routes, we need to unmount the previous page and mount the new page. In this case, the pages are components, home, about, and settings. The first step is to wrap our switch component from React Router DOM with AnimatePresence. Usually, the switch would ensure that only one route renders at a time. What we actually want to do is detect when a route mounts or unmounts, and that way AnimatePresence can animate in a transition. The transitions themselves will be applied to motion elements, like we did in the previous tutorial. If we refresh the page, you'll notice it has no difference. That's because we actually need to use the motion component. So for each component, let's use motion.div. This is just transferring our div into motion.div so we can add animations to it. If we refresh that without updating the props, you'll notice an error message. No exit prop defined on a child of AnimatePresence. This is because a motion element within AnimatePresence requires the exit prop. So let's add an exit prop. This is similar to animate. We'll set the opacity to 0, and in animate, we'll set our opacity to 1. We'll also set the initial state, opacity 0. If we change between the links, you'll notice that the home has a fade in animation, but not a fade out animation. We'll address this soon. Let's update the remaining components, settings and about. We can see a nice animation of opacity between home, about, and settings. Our animation here is technically done. We could leave it like that, and that'd be a respectable animation. A very simple fade in and fade out. You'll notice with our current implementation that there's a lot of repetition. For each page, we'll need to add a motion div and specify initial, animate, and exit props each time. Let's take a look at another concept from Frame of Motion, variants. This allows us to specify our animation ahead of time. Then we can simply refer to the different variants or different states our animation should be in. We can take these properties and put them into a new object. We'll create a new object called Page Transition. Here we can define the different variants we want to have. Let's define in and out. These are the two different states we'll use to fade out or fade in the animation. Now with variants set up, we no longer have to pass an object into initial, animate, or exit. Instead, we can pass in a name, either in or out. And then we pass in the variance prop, which takes in our page transition object. this way motion.div. This way motion.div can figure out which state it's in, either in or out, and look at the variant and decide which props to animate. Let's update the remaining components. Now, all our components use the same page transition variant. We could settle for the simple transition, but let's try something a bit more advanced. After all, that's where frame of motion really shines. Let's try animating the Y position of the component. There's a problem with our animation. When the previous component unmounts, it doesn't play the exit animation as we expect. So we can see them slide in, but we can't see the previous one slide out when the routes change. So let's fix that now. The first step is to add a property to AnimatePresence, exit before enter. This will ensure one animation finishes before the next starts. This is part of the problem solved. The next problem we need to tackle is that this doesn't seem to have any effect. And that's because we need to use the correct keys so that AnimatePresence knows when the route changes. In order to do that, we're going to use the useLocation hook. We want to access the location from the route, and we're going to pass that in to our switch. That way, when the path name changes, AnimatePresence will know when to fire the animation event. Let's test that now. We can see the previous component slide up and the new component slide down. There's another issue which we should resolve. In our exit animation, we can see that the component doesn't fully go off the screen. This is because we're using 100%. Let's change that to use 100VH, which is the viewport height. That way, when the component exits, it will leave the screen entirely. There, that looks much better. Let's see what happens when we try changing Y to X. You'll notice we have a slight issue. Our navigation bar is under the components which have been animated in. Let's resolve that issue now by changing the Z index. We have yet another issue. When our component slides in, it actually exceeds the width of the viewport, and this causes the scroll bar to temporarily appear. This is because the transition we're using is non-linear, and when the new component animates in, the edge exceeds the window. To fix this, we're going to add overflow X hidden. We also don't want to impact the scroll behavior of the Y-axis. We don't really mind if it goes over, but we don't want the scroll bar to temporarily show. Let's take a look at some of the different transitions available in Frame of Motion. First, we're going to create a new transitions object. Page transition is probably poorly named, so we're going to rename it. We rename page transitions to page variants. Next, we'll add the transitions prop to the components that we're going to animate. These are our page components, about, home, and settings. In our page transition object, let's try one of the most basic properties. Duration. Here we can slow the duration down. You can see that's quite slow. If we don't specify a duration, it will use the default. Let's try transition linear. The issue we had before where the component was exceeding the width of the screen was because the transition wasn't linear. Therefore, instead of stopping at the edge of the screen, it goes over a bit, then it corrects itself back into the screen. If we try that now, we can see it stops neatly within the screen. We also have access to spring animations. We specify the type, in this case spring, and we can add some other properties. One of those properties is stiffness. A higher number will cause a lot of tension, and therefore you'll get quite a bouncy effect as we see here. A lower number will cause the animation to ping back and forth very loosely. If we have a look at the tween type, we can play around with different easing. You already know linear, A linear easing means that the animation is consistent across the entire time frame, but we can use some other ones which are commonly used in CSS animations, and animations in general, such as ease in. Ease in, however, is slower in the beginning and faster at the end. We can also try circ in out. You'll notice that it's slow at the beginning and slow at the end, but quite quick in the middle. Experiment with different easing to get the desired effect. To really notice circ in out, we'll update the duration to 3. We can really see the effects this has. Here's another one, anticipate. You notice it has kind of a little wobble at the beginning, and it slows down right at the end. Let's use this one from now on. It's quite a nice animation, and I think it works well with the page transition we have currently. Let's see if we can make some improvements to this. So far we're only using opacity, and we're adjusting the position. How about we try scale as well for a subtle effect? You can see it looks almost 3D as it slides in and scales up. This is all very well, but it continues to come in from the left-hand side. Let's try and make some improvements to this. So instead of coming in from the left and disappearing into the left, how about we use 3 different states instead of 2? This will allow us to have a different animation depending on whether it's exiting or entering. To do this, we'll set up our initial, in, and out. Initial will be when it comes in from the left-hand side. For our output, let's reverse this. Instead of coming in from the left, we'll have it end up in the right. Instead of starting off small and getting larger, we'll scale it up, so it almost looks like it's rotating around. Let's try that now. You can see an animation comes in from the left and slides out to the right, but there's a bit of blank space in the middle. This is because of the property we added previously to AnimatePresence. Let's remove exit before enter. We no longer have the white space, however it's created a different issue. Both components are mounted at the same time in order to play the animations. We can fix this by setting position relative on the container, and also setting position absolute on the motion divs which are animating in. This will enable the components to render on top of each other. Because we only want to see one component at a time, that's fine. And the animations are being handled by frame of motion. This completes the effect we were going for. A slide in and slide out with subtle scale. If we resize the screen, we can see the animation still works as expected. Let's run through some of the highlights. First, we imported AnimatePresence and Motion from Frame of Motion. We use the location from React.Router. We pass the location to our switch so that AnimatePresence knows when to trigger the animations for mounts and unmounts by our various components, About, Settings, and Home. If we remove the location from our switch and remove the key, we can see that it has an undesired effect. We also make use of variants, initial, in, and out, within our page variants. This allows us to reuse our animations for multiple components without re-specifying the styles and animations that we want. We make use of the page transition property. Here we can specify the tween, the easing we want, and the duration. We can tighten the duration up to 0.5, which is half a second. Now, whenever we want to add a new page with this animation, we simply wrap it in motion.div, and we pass the variants and the states that we want to use.
I hope you found this tutorial useful. If you did, then please consider liking it. And if you want to see more tutorials like this, then please subscribe to my channel. I have a question for you. What would you like to animate using Frame of Motion, but you don't know how? Leave a comment below, and I'll see if I can answer it. I might even make a video about it.